robotic thoracic surgery is accomplished by a device that isn't really a remote robot. It is a mechanical actuator. So in robotic thoracic surgery, we're making several very small holes in the patient's chest so that we can get inside with robotic instruments. At that point, you hook the instruments up to a remote controlling device. Once you're hooked up, then the surgeon can, outside the body, operating and driving a console with three-dimensional imaging and with high levels of magnification that exceed what you can get with the naked eye, then you can operate inside the chest and accomplish a variety of different things. And the elegance of robotic thoracic surgery comes in the high magnification, the three-dimensional viewing, the ability to see very fine structures, and the ability to get some very large operations done through very small holes. With robotic thoracic surgery, you unquestionably have a shorter length of stay, you have substantially less pain, you have substantially less complications, things such as irregular heartbeats or pneumonia or wound problems. Most of the adverse events that can occur after surgery are statistically less in thoracic surgery if the procedure is done with the robot or other minimally invasive techniques. Not every chest operation is amenable to robotic surgery because the beauty and elegance of robotic surgery comes largely from the fact that you're making very small holes in the incision. You can do a lot through the very small holes that you make, but at the end of the day, if you're taking a tumor out this big, you have to make a hole this big. If you have to make a hole this big to get the tumor out, it doesn't really make sense to do the whole operation robotically. The things that we can do through very small incisions include biopsying lung nodules, identifying the nature of a nodule that we know is abnormal, but we don't know if it's cancerous or perhaps not. We're able to accomplish lobectomies, which is where we remove an entire lobe of the lung, which is typically done if we know that the patient has a cancer in that lobe. We can do thymic procedures on the thymus gland, which lives behind the breastbone, either for benign disease, such as myasthenia gravis, or of indeterminate disease, such as patients with an unknown mass within the thymus, or sometimes for malignant disease, if they have a known malignancy in the thymus, we can remove it. We can also do esophageal procedures. We can operate on the swallowing tube, the esophagus, which goes from the throat all the way down through the chest into the abdomen. We can do the entire esophageal operation robotically. We can do reflux procedures for people with severe heartburn that does not respond to less aggressive therapy. In broad strokes, that's kind of the spectrum of robotic thoracic surgery, what you can do.